Hello friends, today in this video we are going to see how to generate GSTR3B from Marg ERP software and submit it to the GST portal. Marg ERP auto generates or auto populates your GSTR3B form. You simply have to export it in Excel and then you can review, edit and finalize your GSTR3B. You can copy these values from Excel file and fill your form on the government portal. Firstly, let's understand what is GSTR3B. GSTR3B is a provisional tax return which is to be filled for the month of July and August. Only regular dealers are liable to file GSTR3B. Dealers under composition scheme, ISD or UIN holder are not liable to file GSTR3B. Remember that in form GSTR3B, you just have to provide the consolidated values of outward and inward supplies of the month whose return you will be filing. You do not have to provide invoice level information in this form. As you can see on your screen, the last date of filing GSTR3B. For July, the last date of filing GSTR3B is on 28th August. And for August, the last date of filing GSTR3B is on 28th September. Now let's see the process of GSTR3B in Marg software. Before that, make sure that your software is updated with the Series C version, which you can download from our official website, that is margcompusoft.com. Along with this, you have to download GST patch latest version and then paste it in your Marg folder. So in this way, your Marg software will get updated with Series C. In case you do not have internet access, so you can go to a cyber cafe and download updated Marg software and GST patch and save it in the pen drive. And then install the updated exe onto your PC and paste GST patch in Marg folder. Now firstly, let's go to final reports, then enter on GST returns. Here you will find an option GSTR3B. Enter on it. Then a GST return window will appear, where the user will specify the dates that from which date till which date of the month the GST return has to be filed. For example, if the user needs to file GST return for the month of July, then specify the dates here as 1st July 2017 to 31st July 2017. In report path, you have to define the location where the report will be generated. Then you can view, print or see the report in Excel format or PDF format. If the user needs to view the GSTR3B report, then select view. If the user needs to view the GSTR3B report in printed format, then select print. If the user needs to view the GSTR3B report in PDF format, then select PDF. If the user needs to view the GSTR3B report in Excel format, then select Excel. Now let's click on Excel. So this is the Excel format of GSTR3B along with all the tax details which are filled up. This format of GSTR3B is as per provided by the government. There are total 6 sections in this form whose details we have to fill onto the government portal. Now let's discuss this Excel sheet in detail. Firstly, you see GSTIN of the supplier. Then the company name of the dealer. And then year and month. In month, mention the month for which the returns are filed. In year, mention the year for which the returns are filed. The first section is 3.1. Detail of outward supplies and inward supplies liable to reverse charge. Means details where tax is payable by you. This section tells you that whatever your liabilities are, that is whatever the taxable supplies are there for which GST has been collected or advance taken against the suppliers, plus if any purchases have been done and tax has to be paid on the basis of reverse charges, all that details will be shown here. Here you can see that there are different columns which are being created. The first is nature of supply, under which there are 5 fields. The first is outward taxable supplies other than zero rated, nil rated and exempted. It includes all the taxable supplies. So here the total taxable value will be entered. It does not include supplies which are zero rated or have a nil rate of tax or are exempt from GST. These must be provided separately. Include only those supplies on which GST has been charged by you. Total value of taxable supplies is equal to value of invoices plus value of debit notes minus value of credit notes plus value of advances received against supply for which invoices have not been issued in the same month minus value of advances against invoices. So in this way, your total taxable value will get calculated. If IGST is charged on it, then it will come under integrated tax. CGST will come under central tax, SGST under state UT and cess under cess column. Then is outward taxable supplies zero rated. If you do any export or supplies made in SEZ, that is special economic zone, then those will be entered here. means it includes only those supplies on which GST rate is zero. Then is other outward supplies, nil rated, exempted. It includes supplies which are exempt from GST or are nil rated. So those will come under this. Nil rated supplies are those for which the GST rate is nil or which have been kept exempt from GST. Next is inward supplies liable to reverse charge. It means that if you have provided details of purchases made by registered dealers on which reverse charge applies, in such cases, you have to prepare an invoice to yourself and pay the applicable GST rate of tax. Next is non-GST outward supplies. Suppose there are few categories on which VAT is applicable, for example, alcohol and petroleum products, then in this case, only taxable value will be entered and tax amount will not be entered here. Such supplies, if made by you, then details for them will be entered here. The next section is 3.2. Of the supplies show in 3.1a above, details of interstate supplies made to unregistered persons, composition taxable persons and UIN holders. This section is same as 3.1a, in which the details of interstate supplies made to unregistered persons, composition taxable persons and UIN holders must be mentioned, in which the taxable value and tax amount will be there. UIN holders means those who have a unique identification number instead of a GSTIN. These are specialized agencies of the UNO, United Nations Organizations or Embassy, or any multilateral financial institution or organization notified under the UN, under the United Nations. Any other persons may also be notified by the Commissioner. Next is eligible ITC. It basically means the input tax credit. This section includes whatever the ITC claim needs to be done. That amount will be entered here. The details required for input tax credit must be provided separately for IGST, CGST, SGST, UTGST and CESS. Only total values have to be reported and invoice level information is not required. The first is ITC available whether in full or part. Here the details would be mentioned whether the ITC is in full or in parts. The information or details that is available related to import of services will come under import of services. Then the third number is inward supplies liable to reverse charge. Suppose if any purchase has been made from unregistered dealer on which reverse charge is applicable, then that same amount will be entered here. Fourth is inward supplies from ISD. The tax claim which needs to be taken from the input service distributor, then those details will be mentioned here. On the fifth number is all other ITC. This includes the details except all the import, reverse charge or ISD. Then is ITC reversed. If any ITC reverse has been done, then that details will be mentioned here. Suppose if you have a composite supply which is used for your business and also partially used for personal purpose, then on that equally reverse charge would be done. Similarly, if any input you are getting for an exempted service or taxable service, then it will be equally reversed on basis of rule 42 and 43. The first is as per rule 42 and 43 of CGST rules. It requires the input credit must be reversed for goods and services where they have been used partially for businesses and partially for other purposes to the extent not used for businesses. Similarly, input credit reverse is also required where supplies include taxable, exempt and nil rated supplies. In the same manner, input credit related to capital goods used for business and other purposes for taxable, exempt, nil rated supplies must also be reversed to the extent not used for businesses. Details formulae have been prescribed on how to go about doing this. Any other ITC which have been reversed in the books by you, that is the debit note, will be mentioned here. Then is .NET ITC available A, B. This means the ITC which would be available from A, B, that would be mentioned here. Next is ineligible ITC. It includes on which the input is not given. The first is as per 17.5. This is for your block credit. For example, if any car is purchased for the purpose of business, service taken for any food and beverages, service taken for outdoor catering or services taken for spa, then on these, input tax credit is not available and will come under block credit category. So the details would be mentioned here. Next is others. Those which do not come under section 17.5, then also on that ITC is not available, so that details will come under this. Now let's come to the fifth section, values of exempt, nil rated and non-GST inward supplies. In this point, the user has to specify the values of exempt, nil rated and non-GST inward supplies and also non-GST supplies like alcohol, petrol, etc. received from the suppliers. Here you have to report any purchases made by you of goods and services which are from a composition dealer are exempt, nil rated or not converted by GST at all. Next is 6.1, payment of tax. In this, the final tax would be mentioned and the figures IGST, CGST, SGST, CESS will automatically be picked by 3.1. After that, the figures will come for which the ITC is claimed. In simple terms, the user has to mention the details of tax payable under IGST, CGST, SGST and UTGST and CESS in column number 2 and the details of tax paid in column number 3 to 8. The tax can be paid either through TDS or TCS credit or through cash. The tax paid through ITC has to be shown in column number 3, 4, 5 and 6. Currently, TDS and TCS provisions have been deferred by the government. Therefore, no amount is required to be filled in column number 7. In column number 8, the user has to mention the amount of tax paid in cash for IGST, CGST, SGST or UTGST and CESS respectively. If the user is also liable to pay any interest or penalty, then the same would be shown in column number 9 and 10. The next section is TDS TCS credit. No information is required to be given in point number 6.2 as the provisions of TDS TCS credit has been deferred by the government. Lastly, the user has to verify and sign the return and upload it on the portal. So in this way, we discussed the Excel sheet in detail. Now let's see the process of uploading GSTR3B to the GSTR portal. For that, you will go to gst.gov.in, then click on login, then enter your username and password, then click on return dashboard, then select the financial year which will be 2017-2018, then select the month for which you are filing return. Right now we are filing GSTR3B for the July month, so we will click on July, then click on search. Then under monthly GSTR3B, we will click on prepare online. You will see the different sections of GSTR3B which are required to file. And whatever you have saved earlier will be shown in these tiles. So firstly, let's click on 3.1. So this form will appear on your screen. Here you simply have to copy and type the values from the Excel sheet that is generated from Marg ERP software. Like here, if I have to fill the total taxable value. So for that, I will switch to my Excel sheet, switch to 3.1, which we are currently filing. Then note down the value of total taxable value and type it over here. Similarly, from this Excel sheet, you will note down these values and type it in these cells respectively. Once you have entered these details, you will press this confirm button. This confirm button updates the tile values that you see here. And then we also have to click here on save GSTR3B so that the data that you have saved doesn't get erased if you are exiting from the portal or if your session is timed out. Remember that whatever information we save on the GST portal, so that does not mean that our returns have been filed. It means that we have just saved the data on the portal. You can modify the details later on if you want. Now let's enter data in section 3.2. Here you have to enter value of state-wise details of unregistered taxable persons, composition taxable persons and UIN holders. I have already filled two rows over here for unregistered persons. To add another row, we'll click on add. Now let's switch to our Excel sheet. Switch to 3.2 section. Here you can see we had only made supplies to unregistered persons. That is why the details of only unregistered persons are shown. If you would have made supplies to composition scheme or UIN holders, then the details of those also would be shown. Firstly, we will fill the value of Haryana. So we have already selected Haryana and entered the values of total taxable value and amount of integrated tax from the Excel sheet. If you want to remove a particular row, so you can select that row and then click on remove. So we have filled the data of supplies made to unregistered persons. Similarly, if you have made supplies to composition taxable persons and to UIN holders, so in the same way, you will note down the data from this Excel sheet and enter the same in these fields. After filling the details, click on confirm. Now let's enter data in section 4, eligible ITC. Let's switch to our Excel sheet and switch to the fourth section, eligible ITC. Note down the data from this section and type the same over here. Then click on confirm. Similarly, you will copy the data from the Excel sheet and fill the same for the fifth section and 5.1 section. After filling all the data, click on save GSTR3B to save it. When you will click on save GSTR3B, then this submit button will get enabled. Means you have completed all the sections. When you will click on submit, then your data will get frozen. Means then you cannot change or modify the data. After clicking on submit, your credits gets auto-populated in payment of tax section, and then this payment of tax style will get enabled. Means now you can pay your taxes. In order to pay tax liability, you will switch to the services menu, then payments, then click on create challan. After entering the liability of this month in these fields, you will select the mode of payment. Suppose if we click here on over the counter, so you will be asked to select name of bank. So you will select the bank, then click on generate challan. After you click on generate challan, then the information of your challan will be displayed to you. Now again, let's switch back to our dashboard. Then after filling all the information, you will click on submit. After that, through digital signature or through EVC, you will file your return. So friends, in this video we saw how to generate GSTR3B from Marg ERP software and submit it to the GST portal. Thanks for watching.